Good morning, one and all. I am Dr. Neena Suresh Menon, who is professor and PG and PhD guide in the Department of Homeopathic Materia Medica in Dr. G.D. Pol Foundation, YMD Homeopathic Medical College in Navi Mumbai. Before my presentation, I would like to thank Dr. Bagal Sir, Dean Homeopathic Faculty of MHS and Vice Principal of my college, as well as I would like to thank Dr. Page Ma'am. She is the principal of my college. So today my presentation will be on the topic fungi and homeopathy. So coincidentally, it's the hot topic of today's health scenario. And this is useful for both UG as well as for PG students, as well as for clinicians or the practitioners. So UG, the syllabus of UG, we have here the major four drugs, medicines covered in this one, as well as for PG, the portion will be covering the whole full drug picture will be asked, as well as the group symptoms of fungi will be asked. Along with that, the short note and the comparison will also be asked. So I think this lecture will be useful for UG, PG, as well as for the practitioners, since it's a hot topic of health scenario today. Now, and this one more thing I have to remind you, this presentation will be available in the YouTube as well as in the MUHS online lecture site also. So anytime anyone can visit and see the details, you can refer it, and any doubts regarding to this also you can directly write to me. Okay, so now going into the detail of this one. So the main points which I will be covering in this one will be the introduction regarding fungi, then the contents of mushrooms and difference between the edible and poisonous mushroom. Most of the people are not aware of that one. The health benefits of mushroom, then the fungal poison or the active principle. Then one or two slides I have prepared, especially regarding the black fungus. Next, again, I'm giving importance to the white fungus. This will be followed by the fungal disease classification. Then I will be dealing with the role of fungi in medicine. And this will be followed by the actual homeopathic part, that is the etiopathogenesis of fungal homeopathic medicines, and which will be followed by the introduction of the members of this fungi family, followed by their individual characteristics. Now, when you go into the detail, or when we start with the introduction, that will be the better to. The word fungus, it's derived actually from the Latin word fungus meaning mushroom. This you will be finding early in the writings of Horace and Pliny. So the English word fungus, the fungus is the singular, and the plural word we use either it as fungi or funguses. So it belongs to the group of eukaryotic organisms that include the microorganisms such as yeast, mold, etc., which are familiar to the mushroom. So along with the mushrooms, there is the yeast and mold in this family. Now, the important feature of this one is that the fungal cell wall is made up of chitin. So what is the importance of chitin? Chitin is a polysaccharide, which is made up of the glucose monomers, which is exactly similar to the cellulose of the plant cell, as well as the keratin to the animals. Keratin is actually a fibrous protein, while cellulose is again a polysaccharide. The function of this chitin is that it retains the shape of that mushrooms, and again it creates the turgor pressure. Now, similar to the animals, fungi are considered as heterotroph. And this one, they do not photosynthesize because they don't have the green color. So they try to acquire their food by absorbing the dissolved molecules, especially by secreting the digestive enzymes into their environment. So they cannot prepare their own food. That is another important feature of this one. And when you consider the characteristic feature of the fungi, they are the principal decomposers in the ecological system. So very, very important in our life. If the fungi are not there, then the life itself, the decomposition part is very, very important. Otherwise, there will be accumulation of the debris, etc., will occur. Now, then it belongs to the eumycota, that is the true fungi or the eumycetes, which share a common ancestor, that is form a monophyletic group. So those who are interested in the botany can read in the literature regarding that one. Growth is their mean of mobility, except for the spores. Spores which have flagellated, or they are having wing-like wings by which they travel through the air or water for the dispersion. Now, the principle of biology, which deals with the study of fungi, which is known as mycology. And this is derived from the term Greek, again, the Greek word from which it is derived. Now, earlier, it was considered under the branch of botany, but most of the features are closely related to the animal. So it is even considered under zoology also. Now, the next important feature, the contents of mushrooms. So what are the main contents and its activity? So it contains mainly polysaccharides, then flavones are there, coumarins are there, furans, terpenoids, steroids, steryl pyrones, chlorine, nitrogen, etc. are there. So which again causes the anti-tumor activity, immunomodulator activity, antioxidant activity, anti-inflammatory properties, etc. See the benefit of or health benefits of mushroom. Now, another important feature everyone often mistaken, that is how you differentiate between an edible mushroom and a poisonous mushroom. When you look at the gills on the cap of a young edible mushroom is always pink in color. And when the pink color changes to brown or even black color, it is considered as an edible mushroom. But while a poisonous mushroom is always having white gills, and they do not change the color throughout their entire cycle, life cycle. Okay, so that is a major difference. Now, what are the health benefits of mushrooms? So the most important content of mushrooms are selenium and zinc. These are both are having antioxidant property or the anti-aging property. Other than that one, they are the rich source of vitamin B2 and B3. Vitamin D presence is there. It contains a lot of iron, calories, etc. Even selenium is very much indicated for the bladder activity. Now, when you come to the fungal poison or the active principle, these are the five major active principles you can consider. One is the amanitin, which is the powerful toxin that inhibits the RNA polymerase 2, resulting in the deficient protein synthesis and cell necrosis. So the liver damage will be the result of this bad effects of amanitin. Orelin causes kidney damage. Then gyromitrin, which acts similarly to amanitin, it's carcinogenic and interfere with the function of vitamin B6. So think of those people who excess or even the poisonous or the toxic effect of fungus. Next one is muscarin. Muscarin acts as a nerve poison and it affects the heart and blood circulation. Next one is phallin, which is a tox albumin, which destroys the blood corpuscles. Now let me have a discussion about black fungus, which is the current topic, black fungus and white fungus. So a lot of confusion. See, black fungus, the synonym of that one is mucor mycosis. So many people who recover from COVID-19 have been affected by the fungus, which invade the sinus and makes its way into the intraorbital and intracranial regions. So if its progression is not checked properly, almost 50 to 80% of the patients can die. They are already considered as an opportunistic infection. So it's not a communicable disease. So that is the one thing you have to clearly understand. That is, what's the meaning of opportunistic infection? So when the immune system is very healthy or the immune system is fine, that time this fungus is always surrounded by this fungus. So when the immune system is affected, that time this fungus, who are harmless, take the advantage and invade our system. So that is why they are considered as opportunistic infections. Now the main causes of black fungus include either the uncontrolled diabetes or the overuse of steroids. The symptoms, which will be mainly the black, bloody, foul discharge from the oral or the nasal areas, then the affection of visual, cerebral, sensorium, and the memory. So disorientation will be the presentation, and finally the paralysis occur. The rapid onset of symptoms with poor diagnosis or poor prognosis will be the presentation. Homeopathic medicines are found to be effective. I'm not saying fully 100% effective, but we are having some medicines having almost similimum, or whether both the symptoms as well as pathology are matching with the black fungus. The most important medicine which comes under is cecalicor, which again comes under the fungus family. Other medicines which include anthracenum, apis mellifica, arsenic album, then pyrogen, carbo animalis, graphitis, lacasis, mercuric cyanatum, hydrastis, creosotum, etc. Pyrogen, etc. is again another important drug. Then next is white fungus. I'm not going into the detail of that one. That's not my topic. So just to give an idea about, I'm just added these slides. White fungus, the common name of this one is snow fungus. From the figure, you can identify. It's also known as silver ear fungus. Some call it as candidiasis or aspergillosis, but actually the causative organism is a parasitic yeast. The name of that one is Tremella fusiformis. The symptoms are exactly similar to those of COVID, and the infection can be diagnosed by either CT scan or X-ray. So the symptoms will be either cough, fever, diarrhea, dark spot on the lungs, and with reduced oxygen level. The symptomatic treatment we have in the early stages for mild and moderate cases, especially arsenic album, bryonia, syngona, gelsemium, etc. But in the severe cases, hospitalization and emergency treatment should be done. Now, when coming to the topic, that is the fungal disease or the clinical classification of fungi, when you look into the literature, you can see the different classification. But upon the basis of site of affection, the basic classification includes superficial, which includes the tinea versicola, tinea nigra, pedra, etc. Cutaneous, which again is subdivided into dermatophytosis, candidiasis, etc. Third one is subcutaneous. And fourth one is systemic classification. So the detail also, you can just go and read from the literature. Today, my lecture is not for giving any detailed session of this one. My topic is related to homeopathic materia medica. So all the literatures are available. You just go and refer the detail. I'm just giving a guideline of fungal disease and the medicine related to it. Now, the role of fungi in medicine. This is another important thing. So daily we see COVID cases and the treatment. So we are using a lot of antibiotics. What is antibiotics? Antibiotics are actually fungal. So some fungi which produce substances which help to cure the disease caused by the pathogenic microorganisms, and these substances are called the antibiotics. The term antibiotic therefore denotes an organic substance produced by a microorganism which inhibit the growth of certain other microorganisms. So the most important antibiotics are produced by the mold, actinomycetes, or bacteria. They are used to combat the evil effect of pathogenic bacteria and virus. The use of antibiotics is not limited to any disease treatment. So you have to underline and take a note of this one. Now coming to the homeopathic part. So homeopathy, we have a lot of medicines prepared from fungi. But the out of this 24 medicines I have taken, which are fully proved. So I'll just go to one by one. There is Agaricus muscaris. So when you go to the pharmacy, just don't mention it as Agaricus. See, almost 9 drugs are mentioned under Agaricus. So Agaricus, when you term the term Agaricus word, Agaricus, it can be either Agaricus muscaris or the other 8 drugs also. So you have to be clear which medicine you are buying and giving to the patient. So just let me go through one by one. The first one is Agaricus muscaris, or Amanita is the medicinal name, or the synonym you can call it as. This one is the common drug which can be asked for the UG syllabus. The other ones are useful for the PG students. Agaricus campestris, Agaricus citrinus, Agaricus emeticus. So it is also known as Rasula emetica. One more Rasula will be coming, keep in mind. Then Agaricus panherinus, then Agaricus phalloides. It's also known as Agaricus bulbosus. Next one is Agaricus procerus. Next one is Agaricus semiglobatus. Agaricus tercorarius. See the agaricus, almost 9 drugs are there. Hope you have clearly understood what is agaricus. Next one is, 10th one is agaricinum, that is active constituent of polyporous officinal. Next one is boletus. Again, we have 4 medicines prepared from boletus. So don't use the term only boletus. Either it can be boletus laricis. It is also known as polyporous officinal. Next one is boletus luridus. Next one, boletus pinicola. And last one is boletus satanus. Now comes again the common drug for UG level, that is Bovista lycoperdum, or it is also known as Bovista gigandia. Next one, 16th one is ergotin. Again, it's the active principle. Next one, muscarinum. It's the alkaloid of agaricus. 18th one is Phallus imbudicus. Next one, Polyporus pinicola. Next one, Rasula fetens. Then 21st one is Cicale cornatum or Cicale cerale. So this is again medicine for UG syllabus. Next one, 22 is Solanum tuberosum egrotens. It's a diseased potato infected by the Peronospora infestans. Next one, 23rd is the yeast plant. That is the medicinal name is Torula cerevisiae. And last is Ustilago medis, which is the fungus on corn. It contains ergotin. So this is also included in the UG syllabus. So hope you got an idea about the 24 medicines belonging to the fungi family. Now, what is the etiopathogenesis? So whenever you study a group symptom, what is the importance of studying group symptoms? So if you are not aware, the group symptoms will give you the idea of the characteristic features or the PQRS symptoms of those drugs. So you don't have to go and study the individual drug separately. If with the help of group symptoms, you will be able to understand even the rare medicines also. So etiopathogenesis, so like other medicines, the first action occurs on the central nervous system, which completely were the involving the cerebrospinal axis, producing irritation, inflammation, and even followed by degeneration. So even going to the level of syphilitic manifestation or the destructive features you will be getting in this drug. Second affection on the peripheral nervous system, it produces severe multiple neuritis. Third one, affection on the blood vessel, that the circulation it produces. First thing is the spasm, ischemia, and the gangrenous. So cicalicor is number one remedy for gangrenous condition. Second affection, where there is the dilatation of blood vessels, where you get the relaxation and hemorrhagic feature. So all these remedies are having hemorrhage from all the orifices. Fourth etiopathogenesis include the gastrointestinal tract affection. It causes gastrointestinal irritation leading to vomiting, upper and lower GIT affection. That is the vomiting, diarrhea, dysentery, even affection on the liver and spleen. So it's number one remedy even for malaria as well as for jaundice. Now again, next affection on the female sexual organs. Uterus is the site of affection where you get the hypertrophy, then fibroids or tumors also it is number one remedy. And last affection on the skin where you get the inflammation, exudation, and it's also a number one remedy for eczema. Now we come to the individual characteristic features of fungi. We'll go into the detail. So first affection, that is already we have discussed, is the CNS affection. So the brain where you get the features of coma and unconsciousness. Here the major two drugs, that is agaricus and Bovista, having the affections. Agaricus, the main ailments from or the causative modality is the sexual excess. So ailments after coition or sex is the most important feature leading to either unconsciousness, vertigo, spinal irritation, nervous prostration, etc. will be the features. Encephalitis also indicated in case of agaricus. Now the next drug in Bovista where you get the unconsciousness and they cannot open or the fixed eyes will be the presentation. Second characteristic feature you can mention is the hemorrhagic tendency. So hemorrhagic tendency, we have the medicines, Bovista, and here the character of hemorrhage will be black, passive nature of head with the presence of lot of clot in nature. So bleeding from the gums, black blood which oozes out. Now, Ustilago also it's an emergency bleeding that does not coagulate and passive in nature. Cicalicor again, number one remedy during labor. So where there is hemorrhagic diathesis and the slight wound causes bleeding for weeks like lachesis. Lachesis, phosphorus, etc. Now, next, the third one is chorea or convulsions. In chorea or convulsions, the main medicines are agaricus, where you get the twitching and jerking of muscles. And other than that one, the another characteristic feature you'll be noting is the awkwardness. Even Bovista having this one, they drops things because of the nervous temperament covered in most of these drugs. So the awkwardness and they drops things while handling. This is seen in the drugs like even Apis also has that one, Bovista, then Agaricus are having the same. Chorea, which is aggravation during thunderstorm, and Rasula were the convulsions in general with clonic spasms. Bovista, again, the awkwardness is characteristic. Now, the fourth characteristic feature is the gastritis. So here in gastritis, you can mention the upper GIT affections, abdominal pain is there, the cramping pain, distension from flatters, and as well as the lower GIT affections are also there. Now, Solanum tuberosum aggrotans, it has an indication in ascites for the dropsy with hardness of abdomen. The abdominal pain at night with diarrhea is again common characteristic of this drug. And another important feature, the hypogastric pain in the morning hours. And a particular sensation mentioned in Solanum tuberosum, why I'm going into the detail of this one, this is very rare drug, which is not commonly used in practice also. But as the future homeopaths, you are supposed to use this drug. Sensation as if a spring were unrolled in the left hypochondriac region. Distension of abdomen from the flatus is also there. Ustilago is having pain in the umbilicus before and during stool. Thecal core, more of the lower GIT affections, but the diarrhea, were the sensation involuntary, very exhausting, painless diarrhea, and feels as if the anus remains wide open like a pace. Now the fifth characteristic feature or the affection is the liver, where you get the jaundice features, and agaricus, you will be getting jaundice with convulsions. That will be the presentation. Bovista, jaundice in newborn babies. Now, polyporous pinicola, again, the jaundice with fatigue will be there, and it's also indicated for chronic malaria. Ustilago, the specific affection, that is pain in the right lobe of liver, is characteristic. Sixth one, that is the gangrenous affection, the number one medicine. Thecal core, where the gangrene with dryness, aggravation from external heat, large ecchymosis, blood blisters, and often there is commencement of gangrene. So Agaricus muscaris has indication in Raynaud's disease with the red discoloration of the skin. So that's the identifying feature. Bovista is the person where there will be deep impression, especially knife and all hath melia to, then you will be getting that deep impression. So indented easily from pressure, red discoloration of the skin will be there. Now, seventh one is the complaints during pregnancy. Very, very important drug, this one. So it's number one remedy for miscarriage with early menarche. Other than that one, spontaneous abortion at the third month, then Bovista with spasmodic labor pain, Ustilago with bearing down pain, which is prolonged in nature. And along with that, Ustilago has got feeble contractions, wound off with persistent bleeding of brownish blood. Lochia, for number one remedy, again, lochia, this one, cecal core, ustilago, and all, even miscarriage, that is spontaneous abortion with tendency to miscarriage in the fifth to seventh month. While cecal core is indicated for threatened abortion, especially at the third month of pregnancy, and there is prolonged bearing down and forcing pain will be there. Now, again, coming to female genital organs, so that is a most important sphere of action of this drug. So the bearing down pain in the uterus during and after menses you get, and complaints after sexual excess in case of Agaricus muscaris. Bovista is number one drug for premenstrual syndromes. So PMS, you can just go and refer that one. Metrorrhagia, that is the intermenstrual bleeding, which is aggravation after exertion. And Ustilago has got pain in the hip region extending from the hip to hip before menses. And complaints again after sexual excess is also seen in Ustilago. Now, again, coming to Ustilago, again, nervous headache with menstrual irregularities, all kinds of bleeding from the uterus, then the cervix bleeding easily, metrorrhagia again, characteristic of that drug. Now, cecal core indicated in menses during labor and after pains also it is indicated. So menses, the character is irregular, dark blood profuse with pressing labor like pain in the abdomen, dysmenorrhea conditions, continuous discharge of watery blood until the next period. So it will be continuing. So menorrhagia as well as for the metrorrhagia condition. During labor, the pains are irregular, too weak, feeble or ceasing. Everything seems loose and open, but there is no expulsive action. So, and followed by fainting. After pains are too long, too pain, and it's indicated for the hourglass contraction. Now, next indication in alcoholism. So ailments from alcoholism is common to all the drugs. So you can see the locomotor ataxia or the staggering gait or the delirium tremens you will be getting in this drug. Next one, so Bovista, the features alcoholism, agaricus, solanum tuberosum, aggrotens also, craving for alcohol is there, and mania A42. Now, another, when you come to the delirium features, you can always, that confusion state is there in this remedy. Agaricus muscaris refuses to take the medicine. They always cries and all. Then agaricus tercoreus has the tendency to escape like solanaceae drugs. And there is excitement after convulsions is again characteristic of agaricus tercoreus. Another characteristic feature of this drug is during delirium, they answer in monosyllable, that is in single letters and all. So we have, so it's again number one medicine for stammering condition. Stammering, we have even stramonium and the other drug. So this one is again stammering speech with stuttering, answer slowly, or the sluggishness is more marked in these drugs like agaricus, panhellenicus, agaricus, phalloids, etc. Agaricus muscaris has another feature, that is the learning disabilities. This person or this child has difficulty in learning or late in learning to talk and walk. Very, very important. So if there is late in learning to walk, the medicine is calcareacarb. And if there is late in learning to talk, it is netramol. Both are seen, that is late learning to talk and walk is seen in agaricus muscaris. Hope it is clear for you. Now the next drug is Bovista, where there is stammering in children. Now another important feature, there is restlessness of mind. So all these remedies and the restlessness at night with tossing about in the bed is again characteristic. Now 12th one, that is the increased sexual desire and amorous sexual dreams are again characteristic of solanum tuberosum, aggrotens, Bovista, agaricus, etc. Ustilago has got amorous sexual dreams with pollutions. General weakness after sexual excess, already we have done with. Now, another delusion, another important feature. This person has an enlarged feeling. Distances are enlarged, objects are enlarged. So when you look into the literature also, you find so lot of characters. That is, they feel as if the nose is enlarged or the dimensions of the surrounding are enlarged in size. Or even the hands are enlarged, awkwardness of the fingers, etc. You'll be getting in the drugs agaricus muscaris, Bovista, etc. Now, another important feature, that is chilling. It's exposure to extreme cold temperature. Most of these drugs are thermally chilly in nature. So even chilblains and frostbite are the indications of this drug. Sensation as if ice cold needles are pricking. So it is indicated for the conditions like chilblains, frostbite. So aggravation from exposure to extreme cold temperature. So the drugs solanum, tuberosum, aggrotens, Bovista, agaricus, etc. Now next affection on the mammary gland. See mammary gland, the ustilago has got affection, that is mastitis, and suddenly disappearing of breast milk. That is the indication. Agaricus muscaris, for the breast milk disappearing with brain troubles. Bovista, pain in the left breast is characteristic. Now, next indication is the, or the characteristic feature is the tendency to form new growth. So, it's number one drug for, see the indicated remedies, Bovista, it's indicated for para-ovarian cyst. Next one, boil in the right ear with pain and discharge of fetid pus. Cecale core, which has got indication of lymphoid tumors, boils which mature slowly with green pus. So more towards the suppurative stage, it is indicated. Bloody blisters. Now, Ustilago is number one drug for fibroid tumors. Next one, tendency to develop paresthesias. So paresthesia, the main drugs include agaricus, where there is sensation as if pierced by cold or hot needles. Neuralgia, as if the cold needles run through the nerves. Shooting and burning along the spine. Burning, itching, redness, and swelling as if frozen. So that sensation is very, very important. Next one, considering Bovista, it's indicated for multiple neuritis with tingling and numbness. Cicalicor also has got numbness, insufferable tingling, crawling, starting in the face, on the back, limbs, fingertips, ameliorated by rubbing on the tip of the tongue and throat is also there. Sensation of burning as if sparks in the whole body, feels as if walking on velvet, very, very important. Formication sensation, something as if moving and Jason move over there, that feeling. Formication on the skin is characteristic. Ustilago, there is sensation of boiling water along the back. Now, so after going into the group features, now we come into the individual drugs. Agaricus, when you remember agaricus is considered as the homeopathic penicillin. So what is penicillin? You are aware of. Pyrogen is also considered another homeopathic penicillin. Grimmer, in his literature, he has given penicillinum is between sulfur and lycopodium. So he has given the place of calcarea for penicillinum. So it is considered either superficially, calcarea superficially, or serving as an intercurrent between sulfur and lycopodium. So more literature, just read Grimmer's textbook. Penicillin contains some amount of sulfur and is a milder sulfur and calcarea. So both, all the fungi, that is agaricus as well as penicillinum, are fungi. They are having tubercular miasm, that is combination of psora and syphilitic miasm, as well as hydrogenoid constitution. What is the importance of hydrogenoid constitution? Complaints are aggravated in cold, damp atmosphere. So more towards showing again the psychotic manifestation also in some drugs. Now, coming first to the detail of agaricus muscaris. So this is again for the UG students. So even useful for even drug picture as well as for the short note or the comparison. Agaricus muscaris is also known as Amanita. The common name of this one is toadstool or the fly agaric. It's mainly considered, so this is again, we have already mentioned as a sluggish personality, but the appearance of this person is light hair with the skin and muscles, laxity will be there. Old people with weak indolent circulation, that is the sluggish circulation. And it's indicated for drunkards, especially for their headache and bad effects after a detox. So the see the comparative remedies like Luxomica, Lobelia, Ranunculus, etc. So the comparison can be asked. Then delirium with constant raving, and they tries to get out of the bed, especially in typhoid or typhus condition. So again, another indication, clinical condition for which it is indicated. Next one, even for short note, headache can be asked of those who readily become delirious in fever or with pain, similar to belladonna. We have the other remedies like onosmodium, where the pain will not be accompanied. So the comparison again, you can do. And here the headache of person subject to chorea, twitchings, or grimaces from spinal affections also. So even the deeper affections, you can think of this drug. Here, when we consider the ailments from other causative modality, ailments from sexual excess, coitus after coition, and then exposure to sun, or the extreme cold temperature, that is the frost, fright, mental excess use of mental or mind application or excitement, overexertion, alcoholism, blood poisoning, etc. Very, very important. Next one, when you consider the chorea or twitching, involuntary movements while awake, very, very important. And they stop during sleep, with that from simple motions and jerk of single muscles to dancing of the whole body, trembling of the whole body. And if it is twitching of muscles of face only, then Migale is the drug. So again, the comparison. Again, another important feature, sensation as if ice touched or the ice cold needles were piercing the skin, and even from as from hot needles also. So both the extreme, that is ice needles as well as from the hot needles, you can present it. Now, again, coming back, the staggering gait or locomotor ataxia, uncertainty in walking, stumbles over everything in the way, heel pain as if beaten when standing. Very important, the modalities, characteristic symptom. Spine is very sensitive to touch, like the spider remedies, like the Theridion, aggravation in the morning hours, again, PQRS. Chilblains or frostbite that itch and burn intolerably. Underline this too, itch and burn intolerably. Frostbite and all consequence of exposure to cold, especially in the face. Then this sense of BIR, that is burning, itching, redness of various parts affected. That's also with the swollen feeling and the heat will be there. Now, when you come to the pain, pain is also important. Pain with soreness, aching, especially in the lumbar and sacral region during exertion in the daytime. Very, very important. Daytime and another modality like zygomatosis, aggravation while sitting. Spinal irritation due to sexual excess like the Kali group of drugs, especially Kali phosphoricum. Nervous prostration after sexual debauch. Then epilepsy from suppressed eruption. So all the metastasis features you will be getting. So epilepsy from suppressed eruption similar to sulfur, psoriasis, etc. Even the single vertebra is very much sensitive to touch. Agaricus indicated for prolapse. Post-climactic with the typical bearing down sensation, the comparison with the remedies like Lilium Tick, Murex, Sepia, etc. Extreme sensitive to cold air, we have the other remedies against Sorainam, Kali group of drugs, Calcarea, etc. So all the comparative remedies I have mentioned. Another PQRS symptom of this drug is complaints which appear diagonally. That is the upper left and lower right side is affected similar to antim, tarts, stramonium. And the opposite condition we get in the drugs like ambragrisia, bromium, medorhinum, phosphorus, sulfuric acid, etc. So again, comparison or for the MCQ question, it can be asked. So the modalities already we have discussed with the ailments from also. Now, this is the most important drug, that is Agaricus muscaris. When you come for the PG level, the other drugs are also important, that is Agaricus, Cambestris. We have already done with the characteristic symptoms. We are just refreshing our individual features only. So here, the slightest delirium with the Hippocratic face. Tongue important of all the remedies. Tongue is red and parched. GIT symptoms like nausea, vomiting is there. Pulse is hard, weak, rapid, and irregular in nature. Each and every terms are very, very important. Now, when you come, see the pictures also while going through the slides, because I have differentiated each and every agaricus also. Respiration is irregular in nature. There will be presence of severe cramp, greenness of the skin. So more of the chlorotic appearance will be there. Then it's indicated for formation of abscess, that is the suppurative conditions and even the gangrenous condition also. Skin is very much covered with cold, sweat is there, somnolence and indicated in tertian fever stage. Now, third drug is Agaricus citrinus, see the figure also. All this literature are obtained from the poisonous cases where you get the GIT symptoms like vomiting, violent true cholera is there, deep sopor is there, sopor or sleepiness is there, coma and lethargic condition. Now, fourth drug is Agaricus emeticus. All these drugs I'm just mentioning for the PG levels and for the practice purpose also, you can use all these drugs. Agaricus emeticus is also known as Resula emetica. It's an acrid variety, especially found in Europe. Here, the GIT symptoms, gastritis, vertigo. Another differentiating fever with Agaricus muscaris is that one. The cold water aggravates the symptoms of Agaricus muscaris, while that gives amelioration in case of Agaricus emeticus. I have underlined, you can go through that one also. There is violent burning pain which is present in the stomach region. So the longing for icy cold water, especially during the attacks of anxiety, is the presentation. And another important feature is that the stomach hang on a thread-like, thread which could be momentarily torn into two with icy cold sweat on the face and faintness while moving the head. So that stomach is hang on a thread. That's a sensation mentioned. Another important feature of this drug is aggravated by smelling vinegar, which is unbearable. So vertigo and gastritis are the other presentations. Now, next one is agaricus panherinus. Here, the monosyllable, that stammering, will be more marked in this one. Loss of consciousness, violent general spasm will be there, which is followed by gradual return of consciousness. So the eye character is also important and the face is congested in nature. And this panherinus again has got violent convulsive twitchings is there. Respiration, stertorous and irregular. See the, these medicines are all indicated in the present conditions. Now the COVID situation also, if you correlate also, the importance of fungi is very, very important. And coincidentally, I have taken this topic. Restlessness will be there, tossing about with heat in the head is also characteristic. Now next drug is agaricus phalloides. It's also known as Amanita bulbosus. It is having the poison of great intensity and fatality. So the chilliness with cramps, Hippocratic face, which is again common for almost all the drugs. The tongue is cold in nature. Violent thirst is there. Frequent bilious vomiting, frequent whitish watery stool or the bilious bloody stool is there. Urine is suppressed, voice is hoarse, and pulse is small, intermittent, and hardly perceptible. Now next one is agaricus procerus. See the figures also. Here again, it's obtained from the poisoning cases. Furious delirium or the violent delirium where you get the features of delirium tremens. Then feels as if intoxicated, convulsive spasms, debility, drowsiness, etc. Eighth drug is agaricus semiglobatus. See, globe appearance that flowers, that mushrooms will be having again from the poisonous cases. Stupor will be more marked. Spirits are accelerated. Tongue is parched or cracked and slightly streaked with white coating will be there. And this semiglobatus again have the pain in bowel, urine is scanty, miscarriage in the second month. Pulse can go up to 100 to 120. Ninth drug is agaricus tercorarius, which is indicated again for oppressed breathing and more excitability will be there in this patient. Now coming to the, so we have come to the nine agaricus. Tenth one is agaricinum, which is the active constituent of polyporous officinal. So the common features we have done with. Next one, tenth is agaricinum. 11th one is bolitis larisis. See the figure also. It is also known as bolitis pergens or polyporous officinal. They are very gloomy and despondent, great restlessness after midnight. Gastroenteric irritation is there. And tongue, which is again characteristic, which is white coated, and it turns to yellowish, thick yellowish coated, showing the imprint of teeth also. Taste is also important, which is flat, coppery, unnatural of all the foods, or the taste is diminished also. So nowadays, even the loss of taste, etc., is again can correlate. Next one, bolitis larisis, again coming to the right lobe of liver with frontal headache is the affection mainly. The stool is also important, that is the thin yellowish papillon stool mixed with oily appearance, like drops in the stool you will be. And Leandric stool, what's the meaning of Leandric? Stool containing undigested food particles. So the presence of bile and mucus is also there. Severe cutting pain in the stomach, which remains every few minutes, with a dull, aching distress in the umbilical region and lot of flatulence will be there. Next drug is bolitis luridus. It is also known as bolitis nigrescens. So again, the delirium features predominant in this one, Hippocratic features, that the sunken features, violet color of nose and lips. The cyanotic features are predominant in this one. Intense thirst will be there, violent pain in the epigastrium, subsultus tendinum. So another specific affection of this one is urticaria tuberosa. Very, very important. That's why I have underlined. So speedily followed by death. So very, very poisonous substance. Cold sweat is also the presentation. Now next one, that is bolitis satanus. Satanus, here the diarrhea is important. Dysentery is also there. Unquenchable thirst like aconite. Then sudden desire to vomit. And no nausea between the attack. We call it as projectile vomiting like Ferrum group of drugs. Then there is violent and extremely painful cramps in the muscles of the limbs and face. Then limbs are again, the covering of cold sweat over the whole body is characteristic. Now the 14th one is Boletus pinicola, exactly having the similar features of the other Boletus. 15th one is very important for the UG level, that is the drug Bovista lycoperdum. It is the synonym of this one is by Bovista gigandia. So here it's also known as the puff ball. See the figure also. From the picture you can find out the spores are coming out like a smoke. So persons who suffer from tertiary eruptions, which are either dry or moist in nature, when you consider the constitution, it is indicated for the old maids with palpitation, very, very important. Stammering children like stramonium and similar to Kali bichromicum, all the discharges are stringy, tough, tenacious, stringy in nature, or even hydrastis, similar crocus, all these are stringy in nature. Another important characteristic feature is the usually deep impression on the finger from using blunt instruments, scissors, knife, etc. Then this person cannot tolerate any tight clothing around the waist or abdomen like calcarea, lactases, sulfur, etc. Sweat in the axilla which smell like onions. Now Bovista, see the figure again. You can see the common name of this one again, puffball. And some call it as botted puffball, the exact appearance of warts. So it is also known as botted puffball also. Hemorrhages after extraction of teeth like hemamelis or even from the wound. So from all the orifice and the character again, the dark hemorrhages is characteristic. Epistasis and melena, etc. Great weakness of the joints with weariness of the hands and feet. Another characteristic feature of Bovista is the awkwardness and inclined to drop things from hand like apis. Menses is again important feature, flow only at night and not in the daytime. And the menstrual flow occurs every 2 weeks, which are dark and clotted in nature with painful bearing down pain. So similar to the prolapse uteri or prolapse rectum, that bearing down pain is there, similar to sepia, murex, etc. Another peculiar symptom of this drug is the intolerable itching at the tip of coccyx. Must scratch the parts until it becomes raw and sore in nature. Next one, so the out of this drug, Agaricus muscaris can be asked for short note in the UG level as well as Bovista. Rest of the things mainly for the purpose of your knowledge, to increase the knowledge and for the PG students as well as for the clinician. 16 drug is ergotin. I'm just reminding you so that don't get confused, especially the UG students. Ergotin, which is the active principle of this fungi, beginning arteriosclerosis progressing rather rapidly. There is increased blood pressure. Here the 2x trituration are found to be useful. It's also indicated for edema, gangrene, purpura, hemorrhagica. So most of the students get confused with purpura and puerperal disc. So just this is purpura hemorrhagica. When cecalicor is though indicated, it fails, you can think of ergotin. So it will cover the simulima. Now 17th one is muscarinum. It's again the alkaloid of agaricus. It is having the common features only. 18th one is Phallus impudicus. The common name of this one is stink horn. So similar to the stag. Uska jaisa, horn ka jaisa. See the pick also. Picture you can see. Here indication in case of gastroenteralgia. There will be violent vomiting with profuse salivation. Painful sensitiveness of the whole abdomen with loss of appetite. Devouring thirst is there, sweat is there, vertigo, and the vision is also affected. The object seems colored gray as if in a smoke. He's in a smoke, so that sensation is important. 19th one is Polyporus pinicola. It is the common name of this one is Pine agaric. This is very common fungus you will be. This is proved by Dr. William Burt. And here the prolapse of ANA is the characteristic indication. It's indicated mainly for constipation. So the other remedies we were dealing with mainly for diarrhea, dysentery, etc. This is one drug where you get constipation, hemorrhoids, liver and spleen affections, also indicated for intermittent fever. And the symptoms have a close resemblance with Boletus laryngeus. We have already done with that one. Modalities are important. Aggravation by motion, damp air, and complaints aggravated after stool. Amelioration by rest is also characteristic. 20th one is Rasula foetens. Here indication in case of blindness. Foetens means very much offensive or putrid nature of the discharges. blindness, chorea, convulsions, enuresis, hallucinations, muscular tremor, and chronic spasm, again having the effects of agaric. Muscular spasm, deathly anxiety will be there, and dyspnea again marked. Eye symptoms are also pronounced in this one. There is complete blindness, which is lasting for many days. See, again, the recent conditions prevalent nowadays, you can just correlate. Pupils, sometimes they become normal, sometimes appear dilated, and sometimes they are contracted also. That changeability you will be getting in this drug. 21st, this is again very important for the UG students. CKL core, very, very important. The common name of this one is ergot. So a spurred rye. So it is changed into a black horn-like spur by a fungus known as Claviceps purpurea. You can see the figure also. It's mainly suited to females. So the main questions which can be asked are the female affections, women of thin, scrawny, feeble, cachexia will be marked. So the sunken appearance or the Hippocratic face will be there. Nervous temperament throughout all the fungal remedies. Very lax muscular fiber will be there. Feels as if everything will be loose and open in nature. Passive hemorrhages, black, watery blood will be there, and the corpuscles are destroyed. So it's number one drug. It produces contraction of the unstriped muscular fibers. So the very, very important. It's also indicate produces the anemic condition. Coldness will be there, numbness, fatigue, mortification, and even gangrene. So if, when you consider the ailments from first one, complaints from lifting heavy weight leading to abortion, then injury leading to gangrene, and complaints from sexual excess. Hemorrhagic diathesis, another PQRS symptom of this drug. Even the slightest wound causes bleeding for weeks, like lachesis, phosphorus, etc. Lachesis is having dark hemorrhage like this one. Phosphorus is having bright hemorrhage. Discharges, again, having putrescence, very much offensive odor. Tingling in the extremities with great debility will be there, and weakness will be accompanied feature. Leucorrhea is also important of this one, which is greenish, brown, and offensive in nature. Now, another skin affection of this one, it's indicated for boils, which are small, painful, with green condens, mature very slowly and heal in the same manner. Very debilitating type of skin affections. Face also, you get the Hippocratic face with the blue ring around the eyes, etc. You can add to. And this person has got unnatural ravenous appetite. When you compare with other drugs, you get the loss of appetite, etc. Even with exhausting diarrhea, this person has got unnatural ravenous appetite. And this person has a craving for acids and lemonoid, like Andean crude and all. Now, when you consider the diarrhea, very, very important. It can be asked for short note, etc. Profuse, watery, putrid, brown. Discharge with great foes like Tuja, Gambogia, Crotante, etc. They are very much exhausting in nature, painless, involuntary, and sensation as if the anus remain wide open like Apis, Phosphorus, etc. And another indication of this one in case of enuresis, bedwetting. Of old people, the urine will be pale, watery, or bloody in nature. That is the hematuria condition, and the urine can be suppressed or scanty in nature. Now, burning is another sensation, important sensation, as if all parts of the body, as if sparks of fire were falling on the patient like arsenic. So here the comparison again with arsenic, burning pain, which is ameliorated by heat in case of arsenic. So the differentiating feature here. Another indication of this one is gangrene, which is dry, senile in nature, and aggravation from external heat. Another indication, large ecchymosis, blood blisters, often commencement of gangrenous condition. Then collapse. Collapse in cholera. Skin is cold, yet the patient does not want any covering like camphor. So that's again another important PQRS symptom. The skin is very much cold to touch, and the patient cannot tolerate any covering, especially of the extremities. Now, menses is also characteristic, that is, they are irregular in nature, copious, dark fluid will be there with pressing labor-like pain in the abdomen. So number one for, again, dysmenorrhea, continuous discharge of watery blood until the next period. So menorrhagia as well as the metrorrhagia features you can add to in the list. It's indicated for threatened abortion, especially at the third month, like Sabena, again the comparison, prolonged bearing down, forcing pain. So again, NS feels or the parts affected are remain feels as if they are wide open. During labor, the pains are irregular, too weak, feeble or ceasing in nature. Everything seems loose and open, but there is no expulsive action and followed by fainting. Very, very important. After pains are also too long, too painful and hourglass contraction. Underline, put a star mark on that one. Now, next indication, that is, so almost all the affections of female, you can think in this one, suppression of milk in thin, scrawny, exhausted, anemic persons. The breast does not properly full or fill. Pulse is also small, rapid, contracted, and often intermittent. This one, cecal ichor, another very, very important feature, it decreases the flow of pancreatic juice by raising the blood pressure. So it is very, very important in therapeutic purpose also. Just read from the correlate the clinical part with the medicine textbooks also. Now, when you come to the general modalities, aggravation from heat is there, warmth in general, aggravation from heat is there, and amelioration in the cold air, but uncovering the affected parts gives amelioration. Rubbing also gives amelioration. 22nd drug is solanum tuberosum agrotens. It's indicated for prolapse of rectum. There is offensive breath and odor of the body. Tumor of the rectum, see, very, very important. Tumor of the rectum looking like decayed potato. So that is the doctrine of signature. And this person have dreams of blood, dead bodies, fire, etc. And this person has aggravation by smell of alcohol. Cold water causes suppression or sense of oppression and shock in this person. Next, 23rd drug is the Torula cerevisiae, that is yeast, which is used to ferment and all. So when you, nowadays, even that fungus and all, whatever we have mentioned comes to this one, yeast. Boy, there is recurrent boils or that tendency is there. It's indicated for tinea, that is ringworm affections, headache with constipation, and the perspiration which has a sour, yeasty and moldy odor will be there. Rectum with lot of flatulence and tongue is important, that is the brown at or the brown coating at the base will be the presentation. Torula cerevisiae, again, the hand is cold like ice, similar to the other drug cecal ichor, and they go to sleep easily or the numbness will be there. Itching eczema around the angle is again another PQRS symptom. Now 24th, that is the last drug, that is Ustilago medis, which is present in the corn, also known as corn smut. It says having specific affection on the left ovary and uterus also. Then it's also indicated for hemorrhages with passive in nature and presence of clot is there. It's indicated for menstrual bleeding, postpartum and climacteric hemorrhage. It's also indicated for vicarious menses. What is vicarious? Vicarious means bleeding from any other orifice instead of the menstrual bleeding. So bleeding either from the lungs or the bowels and bleeding between the periods with left inframammary pain is the PQRS symptom. So hope you have got an idea about the fungi. Nature has been experimenting with fungi for a billion of years, perfecting a lot of powerful survival tools. We can use this tool in a fantastic way to revive the damaged ecosystem. That is a necessity of the hour to help offset global warming and even to prevent disease. So it is useful in all the ways. Now, these are the references which I have taken mainly from the Google as well as from the Wikipedia. I have taken the textbooks, especially the Allen's keynote, then Borick, William Borick's textbook of Materia Medica as well as from the Clark's dictionary. That's the most important book I have taken the reference. So now let me quote the most important person, Dr. Hahnemann. Medicine is a science of experience. Its object is to eradicate disease by means of remedies. The knowledge of disease, the knowledge of remedies, and the knowledge of their employment constitute medicine. Hope it is clear for you. Thank you so much for patiently listening to me. And thank you, the MUHS and the team, for cooperating and making this a success. Thank you so much.